you're watching drummerconnection.com, and today we're continuing our journey with hi-hat independence, and this is part three. We're going to keep the same PDF download. You have to grab that off of drummerconnection.com/drum lessons. Right underneath the window where you're watching this lesson, there's a tab that says download. Click on that, grab that PDF and print it. It's got 12 one-bar kick drum patterns on there, and we're going to basically play those on the kick drum while we work out mainly with our left foot, concentrating on now every and or upbeat. Now, this one can be tricky. Before we've done quarter notes, one and three, twos and fours. Now we're going for the upbeat or the and, a little more difficult. Still keeping eighth notes on the ride for now and just a steady two and four on the snare. So now the idea is to keep those three limbs very consistent. Steady eighth notes, nice two and four, and every and or upbeat with your left foot. So we're going to grab the PDF file and just simply start reading each of those one bar patterns. Don't let that left foot shift any, this stuff can be kind of tricky. Let's get started and take a look at number two. There are some of these rhythms on the PDF that intentionally shift the bass drum around so it's not a typical hitting the downbeat every time or always leaving space under the snare drum. When the bass drum hits with the snare drum together in a figure, it can be a little tricky. I want to share with you a looping concept that I've talked about before with linear grooves in Latin, and it works as well with this. What you do is take those three limbs that we had going, ride, hi-hat, and snare, and you keep them very consistent and going, keep playing over and over. Then you look at the bass drum pattern and you go for the very first note. And you simply play that and let the time go by, however long it takes. Then you look at the rhythm and add the second note and let the time go by, and you just keep adding the rhythms on the bass drum until it gets to the end, and then you're looping it and playing the whole figure. I'm gonna show you now a quick demonstration. I'll play each note four times, then move on and add the next one. Like I said, I only gave you an example of four times with each new rhythm that I introduced on the bass drum. The idea when you're at home, relax, take as long as you want, there's no race. Just simply take your time until you get to the end of that figure. I'm going to give you a demonstration now of number eight. What happens here is what I talked about earlier as well. The bass drum does not hit the downbeat. It can be very tricky to get into. If you need the looping process, go for that. Here's an example now, number eight. One final example today, let's move down now and look at number 11. So remember, as I said, this can be a little tricky. You're waking your left foot up and really doing some coordination here with these ands or upbeats. Remember the looping concept. Relax, take your time, no race. Introduce those bass drum rhythms as slow as you need to, but make sure each time you do, everything stays locked in and doesn't shift around. You guys have fun with this. We'll see you next time.